فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters, I advise myself first and I advise all of you to come with piety and taqwa of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, يا أيها الذين آمنوا، oh those of you who believe، كتب عليكم الصيام، fasting has been made obligatory on you، كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون، as it was made obligatory on those who came before you so one may be able to come with piety. So the ending of the verse Allah تبارك وتعالى ordered us to come with and to attain piety. أيها المسلمون، people of إيمان، after days inshallah ta'ala، أيام قليلة يفيد علينا ضيف عزيز، days to come a great noble guest will come our way inshallah ta'ala، شهر كريم، a blessed month will make its way towards our direction. You're all aware of it, inshallah. إِنَّهُ شَهْرُ رَمَضَانِ، it is the great blessed month of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has opened in this month أَبْوَابَ الرَّحَمَاتِ، the doors of mercy. وَأَعْطَانَ فِيهِ الْكَثِيرَ، and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, due to this month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us a lot of honor and respect. Fihi, in it, it is what? Blessing for the believers. And it's a month where the believer can take his provision for the hereafter. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم، he said، إذا كان أول ليلة من شهر رمضان، when it's the first night of the month of Ramadan، صفدت الشياطين، the الشياطين، the مردة الجن، they will be chained، وغلقت أبواب النار، and the doors of the hellfire will be closed، فلم يفتح منها باب، nor a door will be opened from the doors of the hellfire، وفتحت أبواب الجنة، and the doors of Jannah will be open، فلم يغلق منها باب، not one of the doors of Jannah will be closed. وَيُنَادِي مُنَادٍ، a caller will call out and he would say، يَا بَاغِيَ الْخَيْرِ أَقْبِلْ، the one who wants to do good come forward، وَيَا بَاغِيَ الشَّرِّ أَقْصِرْ، and the one who wants to do evil shorten. وَلِلَّهِ، for Allah تبارك وتعالى، in that month is عُتَقَاءُ، people in which he frees، مِنَ النَّارِ، from the hellfire. وذلك كل ليلة، and this is every single night in the month of Ramadan. O Muslims, do you not hear what your messenger Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الذي لا ينطق عن الهوى، He never spoke out from his own whims and desires, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This month, أفضل الشهور العام, it is the best month that lies in the 12 months in the year. The days in it and the minutes that are in it should be valuable to you if you're a true believer. You should benefit from it. How is it possible that this month comes in and every single night Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala wills and He wishes to free a people from the hellfire and you take nothing from it? Its days are mercy, its days are forgiveness, its days and its nights also are freeing one's neck from the hellfire. Isn't it that reason why you came today to the Friday congregation, so Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala can accept a righteous action from you, that Allah can bestow on you His mercy, that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala can free you from the hellfire? Well, in this great month of Ramadan, you will gain that. In this month, ayyuhal ahibba, brothers and sisters, Laylatul Qadr lies inside it. Khayrun min alfi shahr. It is better than 1,000 months. Ibn Abi Shayba in his Musannaf, he states that the previous nations, they used to live for a very long time. As you're all aware, Nabiullah Nuh, Allah says, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ. We sent Nuh to his people. And Nuh was a prophet from the prophets of Allah. فَلَبِثَ فِيهِمْ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ إِلَّا خَمْسِينَ عَامًا. He remained with them, calling them to Allah for 950 years. We don't have that. Our life, as the Messenger said, أَعْمَارُ أُمَّتِي. This life and the living of my nation is between 60 and 70. وَقَلِيلٌ مَنْ يَجُوزُ ذَلِكَ. 60 to 70, and little go over 70. So you won't live for very long. But Allah has given you a night in the great month of Ramadan that is equal to what? Alfi shahr, 1,000 months. You can benefit from it. How can you? If you spend your night standing and you spend your day fasting sincerely for the sake of Allah, you will be able, inshallah, to gain that reward. Ikhwani, the month of Ramadan is what? Fursa, it's an opportunity. Lilirtiqai wa tajdeed. To elevate your status. To renew your actions and change. It is a time to perfect yourself. It's a time to show yourself that you can strive. It is a time when you hasten to any form of good there is. And Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah said, as Ibn Rajab quoted in his kitab, Lata'iful Ma'arif, Hassan al-Basri said, إن الله تعالى جعل شهر رمضان مضمارا لخلقه يستبقون فيه بطاعته إلى مرضاته. The month of Ramadan, Allah has made it an opportunity, a timing in which the believers, they can benefit from, they can take on good things on board. So hasten to the obedience of Allah so you may gain His forgiveness and His pleasement. فيا بشرى. It's a glad tidings, wallahi. من أدرك رمضان. Anybody who meets this month, but واغتنم أيامه, and benefits from its days. واجتاد في ليالي, and its nights, he benefits from it. فارتقى بإيمانه وأعماله, and he elevates through his iman and his actions. عباد الله, إن شهر رمضان, the great month of Ramadan, is a مدرسة عظيمة. It's a school that a person can educate himself. في تهذيب للنفوس. You can work and you can put effort towards your soul. If you're inclined to a sin which you can't let go, this is the month. Doctors, psychologists, they have stated to let go of a habit takes 27 to 28 to 29 days for you to let go of a habit. The month of Ramadan is that opportunity that you can let go of any bad habit you have. In any form or any speech which you see yourself addicted to saying or doing, you have this great month of Ramadan. You can purify your soul. You can work on your outer self. Safa'u lirruh. You can purify your soul. It is the greatest month that a person can ever see. The one who doesn't benefit by asking Allah for forgiveness. How many sins and how many shortcomings do you come with? Either by way of speech, or by way of utterance, or by things that you looked at and you were told not to look at, by the things that you listened to. This month is a month you can run to your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you can ask Him to forgive you. وَإِنِّي, Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَإِنِّي لَغَفَّارٌ, I am one who forgives, لِمَنْ تَابَ, the one who repents, وَآمَنَ, and he believes in me, وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا, and he does righteous actions, ثُمَّ اهْتَدَى, and then he becomes guided. فَبَابُ التَّوْبَةِ, فَبَابُ التَّوْبَةِ مَفْتُوحٌ, the door of repentance is open. وَعَطَاءُ اللَّهِ وَاسِعٌ, and Allah's giveness subhanahu wa ta'ala is out. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, giving a glad tidings, مُبَشِّرًا لِلتَّائِبِينَ, giving glad tidings to those who repent. Allah says, إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. Allah is the one who takes the repentance of the one who repents, and he believes in Allah, and he comes with righteous actions. Allah says, those who have been mentioned, Allah exchanges their shortcoming and the wrong that they have done to good and reward. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ, Allah always is, غَفُورًا, one who forgives, رَحِيمًا, one who is very merciful. أَيُّهَا الْأَحِبَّةِ, الْمُحَافَظَةِ عَلَى الْفَرَائِضِ, safeguard the obligatory acts in this month. Don't be from those people who fast the whole day, but he will not do sujood or ruku' for Allah. He doesn't pray dhuhr, he doesn't pray asir, he doesn't pray maghrib, he doesn't pray isha, nor does he pray fajr, and he fast. He has not taken from his fasting illa al-ju'a wal-atsh. All he has taken from it is hunger and thirst. There's no reward for him. The salah comes before the fasting in the pillar. Al-muhafaza, safeguard the obligatory things. وَقِرَاءَةَ الْقُرْآنِ, recite the Qur'an. أَيُّهَا الْأَحِبَّةِ, Allah has honored us through this Qur'an. Allah said to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ, Muhammad, we have given you, bestowed upon you, and we made it a favor on top of you. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِي وَالْقُرْآنَ الْعَظِيمِ, we gave you the seven verses that repeats itself, Surah Al-Fatiha, وَالْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ. Some of the Mufassirin, they said, it's also Surah Al-Fatiha. Allah is saying, I gave you this Qur'an, لَا تَمُدَّنَّ عَيْنَيْكَ, don't turn your eyes away from the book of Allah. There is where your honor stands. And now you find Muslims who, إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمَ رَبِّي, except those who Allah has mercy upon. They have turned away from the Qur'an. They don't look at it. Even if the month of Ramadan enters, they don't read the Qur'an. They don't go back to the Qur'an. They don't remind me except of the verse of Allah. وَاتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ الَّذِي آتَيْنَاهُ آيَاتِنَا فَانْسَلَخَ مِنَا فَأَتْبَعُهُ الشَّيْطَانُ فَكَانَ مِنَ الْغَاوِينَ وَلَوْ شِئْنَا لَرَفَعْنَاهُ بِهَا وَلَكِنَّهُ أَخْلَدَ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ وَاتَّبَعَهَا. فمثله كمثل الكلب إن تحمل عليه يلهث أو تترك يلهث ذلك مثل القوم الذين كذبوا بآيات الله. Allah mentions in the beginning of the verse, وَاتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ الَّذِي آتَيْنَاهُ آيَاتِنَا, we gave them our verses, this is the book in front of you. Then what did Allah say? وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَى, he turned away from it and he followed his desires. The Quran is your honor, look for it in your honor. Recite the Quran. لَا يَزَالُ لِسَانَكَ رَطَبًا مِنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, do not let your tongue dry from the remembrance of Allah in this great month. وَالِسْتِكْثَارُ مِنَ النَّوَافِلِ, come with voluntary acts. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ, my servant does not become close to me in a matter, أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ, that is more beloved to me, مِمَّا افْتَرَضْتُ عَلَيْهِ, than that which I have made obligatory on him. وَمَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي, and my servant does not remain except, يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ, except he gets closer to me, بِالنَّوَافِلِ, the voluntary act, حَتَّى أُحِبَّهُ, until I love him. أَقُولُ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ ذَنْبٍ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله رب العالمين, له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Brothers, this month of Ramadan that is coming our way, it is actually taking place within the year. The season that is taking place is summer. It's very hot. The temperature's high. You will find that your personality might change. One has to look after what he says, the way he acts, the way he deals, and to remember the speech of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in which he said, "Inna min ahabbikum ilayya," that the one that is the most beloved to me is what? وَأَقْرَبِكُمْ مِنِّي مَجْلِسًا, and is the most closest to me in terms of sit. يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, the day of judgment, is أَحْسَنَكُمْ أَخْلَاقًا, the one who has the best of characteristics, the one who has the best manners. One has to make sure that they watch what they say. If a person insults you, he calls you something which you're not happy with, then say to them, إِنِّي مْرُؤٌ صَائِمٌ, I'm an individual who's fasting. I don't indulge into those speeches. I can't reply back to you. So that person has to make sure. Also, أَحِبَّةِ الْكَرَامِ, this month is a month which brings the Muslims together and unites them, and should be something that should carry on before and after Ramadan. So one should remember the bond and the ties of kinship. Remember the responsibilities of the parents and that which Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala has bestowed upon you. Brothers and sisters, let's be those who benefit from this great month. Let's not be from those who this month comes in, we look at it in the eyes, and that we don't benefit from it. The Salaf Ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in, it was narrated that Abdullah ibn Mubarak, Al-Imam al-Awza'i, and Sufyan ibn Uyayna and Sufyan al-Thawri, they were all quoted and to be said, 6 months, the year consists of 12 months, 6 months, they will be begging Allah if they can meet Ramadan. Another 6 months after Ramadan, they would be asking Allah to accept Ramadan from them. The believer, his heart and his mind looks at that great month of Ramadan and sees it as an opportunity. If Allah has blessed you to meet that month, let it be one that changes your life. I also wanted to remind you all, inshallah ta'ala, after the salah bi'idhnillahi al-kareem, there's going to be a janazah that's going to be prayed. Participate, and to remember the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to hasten to voluntary act. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم اغفر لنا هزلنا وجدنا وخطأنا وعمدنا وكل ذلك عندنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. رب آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكيها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأقم الصلاة.